Hello, my name's Lazrrrr and welcome back to another episode of The Witcher 3 Wild Hunt. So we're picking up from where we left off last episode, in this room. And let's just go straight ahead on doing our tasks. Let's speak
this
to this guy.
This might come as news to the gentleman. The towel wrapped around one's waist is not fitting attire for an audience. The gentleman will kindly dress.
Okay, I have to pick one of these suits, I think. Well, they're not suits, but they're close enough. They all look the same to me, so... Let's pick this stuff up. Do I talk to him now?
This might come as news to the gentleman. The towel wrapped around one's waist is not fitting attire for an audience.
I guess I have to equip it now. That's backwards, isn't it? Eventually. Here we go. Where should I put this? Yeah. Sick. Alright, cool. Let's talk to this guy again.
And they say clothes do not make the man. Does the outfit satisfy the gentleman?
Yep, it does.
A studded doublet and a sword on my back. That's what would satisfy me. But tough when in Nilfgaard.
Yes.
It's a saying. So what now? Out of my nose.
No need. The gentleman's complexion is light enough. The gentleman is to stand before the ruler of the north and south. I must confirm that he knows how to bow.
Confirm anyway.
Confirm away.
Please watch. Leg extended, hand flat, head down, chin to chest. The gentleman will rehearse.
I wasn't really paying attention. I'm guessing that one.
Wrong.
I was wrong.
Once more. Leg extended, hand flat, head down, chin to chest. The gentleman will rehearse.
What the hell, dude?
Gotta be kidding.
Not at all. I am mortally serious. Does the gentleman know the penalty for breaches of etiquette in the Emperor's presence? 200 lashes. I do not wish that upon him. So I will not let him leave until I am confident that he knows how to behave. Lacking fluidity and grace. But we've learned to expect less of Northlings. Come with me.
Right, so we're now following the Chamberlain.
The gentleman will address the Emperor only when asked to, and using the appropriate title.
Your Arch Magnificency.
I see the gentleman is in the mood for jests. I fear the Emperor might not share his disposition. Your Majesty will suffice. Spoken loudly, clearly, and with respect.
Your Imperial Majesty.
Arer et do orde.
Velian namen, vatgen favor.
thought you bowed before no man. Didn't want to disappoint the Chamberlain. We're friends. Take it you didn't summon me to reminisce about the good old days, so...
Silence. My daughter Cirilla, she's returned. And she's in danger. The Wild Hunt pursues her. You will find her and bring her to me.
Why me?
How many men in your army? 20,000? 30? So why me?
You know why. Because she trusts you.
She trusts me, yes. So tell me why you're looking for her. Doubt it's about making up for all those lost years.
For reasons of state, as always. Enough of this banter. You will agree regardless. If for no other reason than because I shall pay you more than you customarily receive for a contract. Considerably more.
Save your generosity for those whose homes your armies have raised. I'll do it for Ciri, not for your gold.
Your motives do not interest me. Only results. Yennefer will tell you the rest. This audience is finished. Merrid! Take him to the sorceress.
So, looks like we're given the task to find Chirella. I believe she's the girl in the dream from like back in episode 1. So, she's a big deal. Right now, I believe we're walking to Yennefer. Because she knows a bit more information than that other man.
Civilization ends in this country.
The gentleman is done, he should see me to retrieve his possessions. I'm guessing I go in
solo now.
This place looks very familiar, not gonna lie. But yeah.
Geralt, that tunic, you look positively smashing.
Dying to take it off.
I'd consider that a proposition under different circumstances. One I might even take you up on. But we've matters to attend to. Now do you understand why I'm at Emir's court?
It seems we're in the same boat now. Ciri, she's really back. No chance he's mistaken.
Look, that's more or less what she looks like now. Or so our agents claim. Our little witch has grown into a young lady.
So they're our agents now? My, my. You've clearly settled in quick.
Geralt, don't twist my words. I know who Emir is. He started this war and its bloodshed. He had my friends killed. But I haven't any other choice. So please, let's not belabor the pros and cons and instead focus on finding Ciri. All right?
Right. Emir said the Wild Hunt's after her. I'd find that hard to believe before what happened yesterday. How did they track us down?
Because of me. You see, I've spent months searching for Ciri, using locating spells, haruspicy, geomancy, anything, really. I knew the Wild Hunt might sense it, perhaps even find me, but I thought I'd trick them.
Well, guess you were wrong.
Sensed them on my trail, hunting me, for some time. A If not for you and Amir's soldiers, they'd have gotten what they were after. I can't risk another encounter like that. It's time to put away the magic, turn to more traditional methods. To the best tracker I know. You must find her, Geralt. Before the Wild Hunt does.
So where has Ciri been seen, exactly?
In two places. Velen and Novigrad. The trail in Velen is most promising. You should make that your first stop. Ask for a merchant named Hendrik at the inn at the crossroads. One of the Emperor's agents. He should get in touch with you.
That's it? No passwords? Secret handshakes?
None. Sorry to spoil your fun. Your boyhood fantasies about the crafts of the trade. All we have in Novigrad are unconfirmed reports, rumors. But there you will have the help of our mutual acquaintance. Triss Merigold. Apparently she's got a cozy flat on the main square.
Sure she'll be delighted to see me. What about you? What will you do?
I shall sail for Skellige. There was a magic explosion there recently. Blew half a forest down. I believe this had something to do with Ciri. I'll be in Caer Trold. Join me there once you've learned something.
Time we get going. We need to find this girl.
Guess this means
that seems to be on the mission.
Not my preference, but I understand. Clock's ticking.
It is indeed. So why don't I teleport you to Velen, get you there at once?
Not gonna happen. I'll go on horseback as soon as I can get changed.
Have it your way? Oh, and you really look quite dashing in black velvet.
Think so? Maybe I can have some of my armor lined with it. Good luck, Yen.
Same to you. And if you wish to learn what's happened in the world while you and Vesemir roam the wilderness, talk to Ambassador Vaartra. That's him over there. And Geralt, I know it's wartime, but try not to be a hero, all right? Just check those leads and come back to me in one piece. I shall be waiting.
Sweet. Let's get going. So we've got quite a journey now, which is awesome because I like a good story.
How might I serve the gentleman?
By returning my things.
Citrus and cloves. The fragrance will keep the gentleman's robes fresh somewhat longer.
Thanks, bunches.
The Emperor is not known for his patience. He wants his daughter back safe and sound, as soon as possible.
Yeah, mentioned something of the sort. So long.
A deserter from
okay.
The Squire.
Oh, there's a quest over there, I think. But we need to get to somewhere. Wait, what? Travel to Velen. Switch continent. To return to the map of the region where you are currently located, press. Okay. So I need to go here. I'm guessing I just go here. Right, we need to speak to someone at the inn and gather more information. I need to avoid all contact with enemies. We've actually got quite a long way to go. Over 300 steps. Went the wrong way. I think it's up here somewhere. We're entering some sort of village.
Whoa there, Roach.
Okay. Left. Hello.
Looking for a man. Goes by Hendrik.
What do you want with him?
Want to talk to him.
What about?
Give me a bottle of something strong.
You gotta go. I'll open the back way for you.
Expecting visitors.
We got company. Who is it?
Innkeeper, Vodka. Who's this?
Brave warrior, looks like. Got two swords, see?
Oi, great boy. What's the point of having two swords?
Wonder if he keeps an extra prick in his trousers too.
You fucking deaf. Gonna say who you are? Or do I need to loosen your tongue with me knife?
Back off or die.
Someone who'd prefer not to be bothered while he's having a drink.
Hear that? We've a distinguished gentleman in our midst. Shine your boots, governor.
No. Wouldn't want the grime in your hands to rub off on them.
Bolo, did you hear what I heard?
Go away, or I'll kill you.
Damn it. Enough.
Is there gonna be another fight?
What? Lost your nerve?
What? Oh god, I'm so bad at this game. Maybe I should have put the difficulty down. I probably should take the fight slower. There's going to be a lot of deaths throughout this game. gameplay. Whether it's boss fight or just random strangers. But we'll get through it all. Person is killed. There we go, much easier.
Have you any idea what the Baron will do when he learns of this butchery? The village! He'll tear it apart before anyone can say it was some wandering mutant done it. An iron fist he's got!
Where's Hendrik?
You dad! Understand what I'm saying? Baron won't let this stand!
Calm down. Your Baron's no idiot. Seriously doubt he'll think you locals cut his men down with farming implements. Now where's Hendrik?
Man lives in Heatherton.
Don't know where that is.
Other side of the hill. Looked that away this morning, saw a strange glow. Imperials on the raid, perhaps. But who knows?
But... we know where he is.
Thanks, Innkeep.
Go out the back. More of the Baron's men in the village.
No need to worry about me.
I'd rather you not make any more trouble for yourself, for us both.
Thanks, Mr. Innkeep. Oh, are you kidding me? Oh my god, what's that? Okay, so I've currently fixed the lagging issue. It was fraps being annoying. I just changed my recording software. And yeah, so let's move on this task. What do we need to do? We need to call... I need to get to my horse, but that means I have to kill these guys. I don't really want to fight him, to be honest.
Well, how long are you gonna make me wait? Oh, damn it!
Oh my god, they do so much damage. Get to my horse now. Oh no, this is that guy with a crossbow. Right, let's get going. Let's go. Is this the right way? Yeah, it is.
Run, Roach. Slower.
But can I jump over this? Oh, okay, let's go. Okay.
Strange, like dropping into a deep cellar on a hot day.
Ah, oh, there's more enemies. Oh my.
Come on.
These guys do a lot of damage. Oh, I guess I can't speak to him until I kill these guys. What? I died. Oh. I need to like not die. I should have like a death counter for every time I die. I reckon I'll hit like 50. By the time the walkthrough is over. These dogs are like pretty tough. Or maybe I'm just super bad.
Run, Roach.
Maybe we should start at full HP.
Like dropping into a deep cellar on a hot day. The mist.
I lose so much HP just from a couple of attacks. I should probably...
Not good.
Oh, shit. I just need to like run away and regen my health. These dogs are savage. I've died again. Oh my god. What I'll do is I have one more attempt, and if I don't do it, I'll kill him in the off time, and we will return next episode, after I've killed them, otherwise we could be here for a long time. If this game was set on, like, the easiest level, or second to easiest, Maybe I could do it. Alright. Let's try again.
Air is strange. Like dropping into a deep cellar on a hot day. And the mist.
Wait, what is my... What does this do? Right, okay. The problem is three of them. I wish it was just one. What, I've already lost 50% HP? Out. if I attack one dog, I'll get hit by another dog. Which is so tragic. Right, it's just one left. Let's see if I can do it. Yes, I've done it. Finally, after my third attempt.
Leave me be, whoever you is. Get away.
Calm down. It's over.
Aye, it's over. All's past, never to be restored. I'll not forget that ever.
Looking for a man named Hendrik, supposed to live in this village.
Aye, he did. No longer. They nabbed him in that hut. If you'd have heard the cries, sir, if you'd have heard how a man can scream, how he can suffer.
Tell me what happened.
Tell me what happened here, step by step.
They took him. Took them all. The sun was waning, see? And the dusk went crimson like blood. Thought to myself, strange. The toads, I cannot hear them. Save terror through and through. Hendrik screamed. Then he begged. By the end, he could do naught but moan.
Just wonderful.
Weren't here long, the terrors. Yet the village froze like in the heart of winter.
You in that hut when they rode off?
No. And I'll not set foot there. Never.
Farewell, and peace of mind to you.
Okay, so I think this is a good checkpoint to pause and take in what's happened. But anyway, if you enjoyed this episode, please leave a like and sub if you already haven't. And see you on the next episode. Peace.